Hello guys, hello people, welcome back to Hot Ninja Entertainment, where you get the latest news and entertainment from Nigeria. If this is your first time seeing my face, please consider to subscribe and put on your notification bell, and don't forget to share this video. God bless you as you do so, and God bless my subscribers as well. So guys, without wasting much time, guys,
they forgot that our brother who for our sakes and the sakes of our children's children to secure our own future, our heritage and inheritance, is incarcerated unjustly. You went about drinking and enjoying yourself. I'm not against it. Somebody, Oluchi Floyd, said that Tonto Dike focuses her attention on the in the north, whatever she's doing. That's her business. You know, there is something fundamentally wrong with some of our people. They don't have the desire of our land, our people in their hearts. For the sake of money, they can sell everybody, just like our politicians want to sell us and win favors from people who are not supposed to be your masters, by reason of the fact that you are a man that God created and appointed a Jewish man in Nigerian territory. No wonder Jesus told the Jews the day he came into Jerusalem, as he was riding on that donkey, that ass, he told them that he looked at Jerusalem and began to weep. He said, if only you knew the day of your visitation. But because you don't know, you shall not see me again until the day you say, blessed is he that cometh in the name of the Lord. The Hebrews translate it to Baruch Abba Beshem Adonai. Until the day the Jews said, and they will see it that day when Jesus will come, after Israel must have been dealt with expeditiously by the wicked nations that will come from the north to run the whole nation. The Bible says that Jesus will descend from heaven and stand on the Mount of Olives according to the prophecy of the angel that told the apostles. And it shall be a valley called the Valley of Jehoshaphat. That is where they will go and be protected. Then they will now know that this was he whom they crucified and rejected. And they will weep like a woman weep over her only child. That is the day they will say, blessed is he, Baruch Abba Beshem Adonai. The Lord sent a son among us, gave him boldness, gave him wisdom, gave him understanding, gave him favor. Why is it that Nnamdi Kanu is not branded a terrorist in America, United Kingdom, France, Germany? Why? Because they know that this young man is saying the truth. He came in a very, very advanced way of exposing things. He didn't use violence. He talked. He analyzed. He did expositions. He looked at things very well and presented it to the whole world consistently for years. Since 2014, he kept talking and talking until suddenly people's eyes started becoming open. The eyes were popping up. And that's why you see this massive movement of the Duduas today is courtesy of what Nnamdi Kanu started. The Middle Belt, the same thing. The reaction from the North and the Fulani against these people is because of Nnamdi Kanu has spoken into people's eyes being open, that the agenda to run the country and fulanize it is being truncated, because not by violence, by simple argument, talking, convincing people. Yet within the Igbo race, Igbos don't even care. Some Igbos don't care, not all Igbos, because most of us care. We believe who we are, where we come from. And those that don't believe, who are too concerned with their money, if you talk, they will say, what is your concern? I do what I want to do with my money. That's right. But brother, your timing was wrong. We are mourning. The mourning is not the mourning of defeat. It's a temporary pain, which eventually we shall come out of it stronger, better, and be the champion of the cause of human liberation in the whole world. Everything that started with people like Martin Luther King and others and within the black race will be concluded in the person of Nnamdi Kanu. He is the final icing on the cake. As he applies it, henceforth, many countries will liberate, especially the black world. So it's a shame that they called you dogs. Somebody looked at you, all of you, including you, Kubana, what's his name, Kanari, and others. I think I saw this other young man who was this man's friend, what's his name, and he repeated it on Facebook. What's the name of this man that drums and dances? I've forgotten his name, he's a prophet. I've forgotten his name. His fair complexion, this young prophet, I think, from Onichade. Uh-huh. So, he came out and that he's not his friend, that they were part of his life from childhood, but he's not his prophet. If you can tell me his name, I'll put it here. What's this young man's name? Who dances? Most of these Nollywood actors go there and dance with him in his church. He put them on the floor in a kind of a deliverance. So, I want to bring your mind, Kubana, to something which maybe you don't understand or some Igbo leaders don't understand. When Jomo Kenyatta was branded a terrorist to be killed by Odumeje, this guy that is a friend to Odumeje, and said that it is not his prophet. I think I saw his face there, I don't know. Now, when Jomo Kenyatta had problem, it was an Igbo man called Nnamdi Azikiwe. Look at that word, Nnamdi, take the word. That came to his rescue and aid. And that saved him so that Jomo Kenyatta for the liberation of Kenya will materialize. And to show that Igbo brotherly kindness which we had, Nnamdi Azikiwe brought in Jomo Kenyatta, named Kenyatta Market after this man and Kenyatta Road. Now, after many years, Nnamdi again came up. This time, entered into Kenyatta's country based on this understanding that was established by the forefathers. We did you a good deed, a good thing. He came into his country and Jomo Kenyatta's own son was in charge. His name is Uhuru. Uhuru now took Nnamdi. Remember, this one is Kano, but it's Nnamdi to Nnamdi. Kenyatta's liberation started from, Kenya's liberation started with Jomo Kenyatta and Nnamdi helping. And now Kenya, Kenyatta's this thing collapsed. The termination of Kenyatta is with Uhuru, with another Nnamdi, who came and he betrayed him, and is denying it. The whole world knows that Kenya is lying, that Nnamdi Kanu was tranquilized, beaten and brutalized before being sent to Nigeria. Do you think it's coincidence? No, God is planning something, because if I recall your mind back, Donald Trump once said that I said that Kenya is corrupt and I did not mention Nigeria. Why? Because when talking about evil people, you don't talk about the devil. So Kenya is evil. Who is the devil? That was what Donald Trump said before this thing happened. Remember, it was this same Kenya that Nigeria had courtesy of Nnamdi, as it were. Then, after many, many years, a man came up and made a comment. Why? It's no coincidence. And he said, Kenya is corrupt. I did not mention Nigeria because when you talk about evil people, you don't mention the devil. So the devil is not included in people that are evil. He is the organ, and it is only evil people that carry out the agenda of the devil. And so, Kenya carried out the agenda of Nigeria, which the whole world is seeing now, that the abduction of Kanu violates international procedure of extradition. It is like a state committing a crime. Kenya. Kenyatta. And When Trump made this comment, people didn't take him serious. But you have seen it has come to pass. Why did he pick these two nations? It's about 4 or 5 years ago. Why is it that it so happened that this thing came to take place now? Between Kenya and Nigeria. I leave you to check that out. Nothing happens before God unawares. He's programming everything. Though we may have been beaten, smitten now, we are not dying. We shall rise because it is God who fights the battle. The same God that fought the battle for the Jews. They did not fight. They did not kill anybody to get their independence. They kept talking. Benjamin Grossman spoke and spoke and spoke. He was the first Jewish leader. Spoke and led the Jewish people. And they granted them as a nation when the vote was counted in the UN. And Biafra is heading towards it because by referendum, Pakistan left India, Bangladesh left Pakistan, Sudan, South Sudan left Sudan, Eritrea left Ethiopia, we have Somaliland. So what we are asking for is not a crime, we don't hate anybody, it's just that we want out so that we can build our own country, put our own laws and see to it that everything established is established. And then executed fully to the letter, so that we don't have to be traveling to Britain, France, America, and go there to stay. We can stay in our own country, develop Biafra land, so that the American man can come and visit Biafra and see a showcase of African technology, expertise in development.
Thank you for watching that video. And guys, before you leave, don't forget to subscribe. See you guys in my next video.